One of the most hardest skills to gain as a software engineer is problem-solving skills. And many new and upcoming developers will agree with me on that. Yes, you see, we are in the age of AI. Tools like ChatGPT, Gemini, and Claude always makes it easier for us to get answers to our problems. But relying too heavily on these AI tools will weaken our critical thinking skills, which in turn will make us really bad at problem solving. So in this video, I am going to show you the step-by-step process I personally use to solve my problems in my software engineering career. Mostly, when I want to code something from scratch, I'll be staring blankly at my IDE, not knowing where to start, because I think the problem is too hard for me to solve. But that is called overthinking. You see, this is what I mostly like to do. 1. I try hard to understand the problem. I write down the problem in plain old English. I don't try and sneak in some programming jargons. Nah, this is plain old English. I like using a pen and paper for this. By writing the problem down in plain old English, it helps me to understand the problem and its requirements better. Sometimes, I also see that if I can draw some diagram to explain the problem, it also helps me very much. Now, when I'm fully convinced that I can explain the problem to someone in plain old English, or probably using the diagram that I wrote earlier, then I will see that I truly understand the problem.
Let me explain.
After understanding the problem, the second thing that I do is to try and break down the problem into small manageable parts that I can solve very easily. You see, by breaking down the problem into small parts, it makes a huge and daunting task look like a small task that I can achieve. Now, when I'm done breaking them down, I pick each problem and try to solve it. This is how I mostly go about solving each sub-problem that I find. First of all, I try and write down the solution I have in plain English. So no coding, no if statements, no for loop, but rather, how can I solve this problem in plain old English? After that, I convert the plain old English into a pseudocode solution. So this is where I add my for loops, my constant, my variables, and my functions. With the writing of the pseudocode, I mostly use pen and paper, or I comment out the pseudocode in my text editor or IDE. Sometimes too, I will probably not know the solution to that sub-problem that I am solving. So this is what I normally do. I try and find how other people have solved similar problems online. So I mainly Google and I search for my problem online. And when I get some code that I can use, I don't just copy and paste them.
I don't want peace. I want problems always.
Rather, I try and write that solution down, making sure that I fully understand whatever that person is doing. Before we move on to the last part, please consider subscribing if you find this breakdown really useful. Also, I share more content like this to help you level up as a developer or as a software engineer. The last thing that I do when I'm done with understanding the problem and writing down the solution in pseudocode is where I turn the pseudocode in plain English into actual code. Now, this process, I repeat it until I've solved all the sub-problems that I broke down earlier. So there you have it. If you meet a giant problem, first of all, understand the problem by writing it down. Secondly, break the problem into sub-problems. Third, figure out a way to solve each sub-problem on a sheet of paper. If you can't do that, try googling the solution. and see how other people are solving it. Lastly, turn your written down solution or your written down pseudocode into code. This was the process I used to solve creation of a unique file name for every file or every markdown file in a library that I am building. If you want to know more about that, who knows, probably in the near future I'm going to make a video about the library that I am building. But just remember that problem solving is a skill, and with every skill, to become good at it, you need to practice that skill. So please try using this approach over and over and over again, and rest assured, with time you will become a good and great software engineer. Hey folks, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Let me know how you also approach problem solving, and see you in the next video, which is Thursday. Happy coding.